Welcome friends, welcome to the backyard. As you can see, I've got the fire pit going again, and today we're gonna do some flank steak tacos. So I'm gonna make a marinade for the flank steak, and then we're gonna grill up some vegetables to make a really good tomato salsa. So first, the marinade for the flank steak. I'm gonna put into this bowl some garlic, some chopped jalapeño pepper, salt and pepper. Now, I just did some freshly squeezed grapefruit juice, so I'm gonna put that in. And I just squeezed some limes, so I'm gonna put that juice in as well. And some olive oil. Now, I used lime and grapefruit. You could use any citrus that you want. You could use limes, lemons, grapefruit, orange. Orange would be really good. The idea is that you just want that bright citrus flavor and you want the acidity to help to start to break down the fibers in the steak. So, just giving that a quick mix. And I'm gonna put the steak, it's still spring here. There are maple flowers everywhere. So, put the steak in the bottom of this pan and pour in some of the marinade. Stick the other steak on top and pour in the rest of the marinade. Now, if you're someone who uses Ziploc bags, that would probably be the best way to do this, or the easiest way to do this. I don't often use them. I don't often have them here in the house. So I will just flip these around 4 or 5 times over the next couple of hours. I wouldn't let this marinate more than, say, 3 hours. I'm just gonna let it marinate as I make the salsa and get the fire ready. Now, while the steak is marinating, I'm going to start making the salsa and grilling the vegetables. So I've got some onion, tomato, jalapeno, garlic, and I just want to blacken them on the grill if I can manage. Now, the toughest part about cooking outdoors over an open flame or an open fire like this, campfire cooking, has got to be managing the fire. That is the most difficult part, and I'm getting better at it. I used to do this quite a bit. For a long time, Julie and I did a lot of camping. And there was a period of time where we lived in a tent for 5-6 months while we were working in the bush in Northern Ontario. Did this all the time. Took a long break though, and I'm getting back to it. And the keys seem to be, you're gonna use a lot more wood than you thought you were going to use. You've gotta start the fire a lot earlier than you thought you were going to start it, or you wanted to start it. And you have to manage putting new wood on, and it has to be super dry because you don't want to get that really bitter smoke. Sometimes you can get a really, really bitter flavor into your food if your smoke isn't clean. So just some tips, and you got to watch the fire. So I just want to grill these now until they're blackened on the outside and softened and mostly cooked through. Keep your eye on them. So this is just a little pot with some navy beans and jalapenos chopped up inside. And I'm just gonna cook that alongside here while I finish off these vegetables. Now I'm gonna say these are pretty close to being done. They're nice and roasty and soft. So what I'm gonna end up doing is I'm gonna peel the tomatoes and the outer skin off the jalapenos and then squeeze the garlic just into a food processor. Give it a quick whiz just to bring it together. If I had a molcajete, if I had a nice big molcajete, I would just put it in that and grind it together. Easy peasy. That would be the way to do it. That's the way I learned to do it, but I don't have one. So food processor it's going to be. Looking good. I'm gonna say that looks great. So, off they come. Now, I put a lid over just to help it steam out some of the skin. And you just wanna peel off the really burny parts. Oh, it's still hot. And the only thing I'm gonna pull off is the stem from the jalapenos. I'm gonna put everything else in full. Okay, last onion. Peel off most of the brown, the blackened bits, and I'd left the little piece of root on. Just pinch that off with your fingers. It comes off really easy. Okay, let's give this a taste. Pretty sure that it'll need some salt. It needs some salt. It also needs a little bit of an acid. So I think what I'm gonna do is squeeze in some of these limes that I've grilled over the fire as well. Maple flowers everywhere, falling from the trees. Okay, so some salt. It's quite a bit here, so good amount. And then these little roasted limes that I did. Stir that in and see what happens. Now, these flank steaks won't take long to cook at all. And I'm shooting for medium rare. Let's see if I can get there. This pot of beans is looking pretty good too. There we go. Okay, let's check the temperature. A little bit over, 135. 138. Those are ready to come off. Maple flowers everywhere. And I've also got some little limes on here, toasting them up nicely. While the steak rests, I'll just toast up a couple of tortillas. Okay. Let's slice this across the grain. This has been resting for probably 15 minutes, and I have overcooked it. But it's still gonna be fantastic. Fall apart.
It is taco day.
Taco time. Okay, so.
Hey, friends.
Flank steak, marinated, cooked over an open wood fire. Tortilla, slightly roasted. Maple flowers everywhere.
What's going on?
Fire roasted salsa.
So should I put a little salsa? Or?
A little bit. It was a little bit hot. It was a little bit hot, a little bit hot. And fire roasted.
I'm excited about those beans.
Those beans, yeah.
I know the salsa is going to be good, but I am super excited about the beans. That's something that's kind of new.
I tried to get cheese. The Latin market was closed. And it's been closed the last couple times I've gone. So I'm hoping that...
That's not a long-term thing. Yeah.
Might put another piece of steak on there since there's no cheese.
You think you need extra?
Let's switch places. Okay. Cilantro. I'm going to put some cabbage because I really like cabbage on my tacos. Some salsa. And.
Switching spots again?
Look at that.
Here's this working out. I'm still working on mine. I still need cabbage and stuff.
Okay, let's switch again.
The cilantro. Ah! It's windy, apparently.
That lime is really potent.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Those are all really good.
Yeah. So all the flavors come together.
Mm-hmm.
It's just those tiny little limes.
That was a little too much lime, I think, on mine, too.
A little too much lime on mine.
I feel I might have chintzed out on this. I'm going to add a little extra. I was overly cautious based on your warning.
Okay, so you don't need to do this over an open flame, although it's really fun. It's so much fun standing around an open fire, hanging out. There's something about that that is just fantastic. But you could do this on a charcoal grill. You could do it on a gas grill. You could do this on a hot frying pan or skillet on the stovetop.
There's options.
So many options. Top it how you like it, but that salsa's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.